Remember that some prospects are simply never going to buy, and all money's not good money. In which case, it's okay to just let it go. If they don't have sufficient budget and they're not a fully qualified prospect, you know, I always talk about that, a qualified buyer, then it's important to let it go or downsell them into another program. That's important. So let's talk about handling objections. First, I want to start with a system. The system I use is on page 199 of Power Your Profits. So I've been using this for 20 years and it works. Follow the system. It eliminates those victory days. What are victory days? They're good days. They're bad days. They're good sales calls. They're bad sales call. The reality is consistency is the key. So I want to break it down in four simple steps. The first step is listen. Don't just spell out your client's objections. Actually listen. God gave us two ears and one mouth for a purpose, to listen twice as much as we speak. Chances are you'll be able to anticipate potential objections before they even occur. I'll talk through the most common concerns and how I overcome them rather than just jumping into the answer or worse, cutting off our prospect. We have to take time and share their concerns in full to be sure to give that prospect time to speak. It will help them feel genuinely comfortable and know that you're looking for their best interest at heart. It also increases your chances of closing the deal. Number two, let's understand that people are complex. You know that, I know that, and we don't always say exactly what we mean. Even when we try to, our words might be misinterpreted. So it's important to paraphrase your prospect's concerns to demonstrate that you actually understand their concern and their objection. Or even if you didn't fully understand, it gives the client the opportunity to correct you. So for an example, I'll say, let me just be clear that we're on the same page. Your concern about onboarding costs are too high, or it'll take too long, and the costs are too much for you. Is that correct? And they will correct you if it's not, or they'll add if they need to add more. There may be additional underlying objections that the prospect hasn't even voiced or only alluded to. You have to listen and do the discernment, right? You want to help dig up all their objections before you even make your final offer, so that you can respond effectively. Okay, number three, whether or not they seem like a serious issue to you, it's a serious issue to them. If they feel like you're not taking the objection seriously, or that you're trying to steamroll them into an agreement or a contract, it's unlikely we'll end up closing the deal. If the objection is something that you have authority to handle yourself, don't be afraid to do so. Otherwise, explain that you need to run it up your chain of command. So I always say, let me check with my operations manager. Let me check with my calendar. Let me check with finance department. Who are all those people? Me. But it gives them the opportunity to think about it and you to think about it before you come back. So number four, you want to confirm and reiterate the objection and confirm that you'll be able to overcome it. The prospect will be happy to move forward with the deal if they feel heard. The second part is really important. There's no point in taking the time to overcome an objection if you still won't move any closer to securing their business. Remember that some prospects are simply never going to buy, and all money's not good money. In which case, it's okay to just let it go. If they don't have sufficient budget and they're not a fully qualified prospect, you know, I always talk about that, a qualified buyer, then it's important to let it go or downsell them into another program. That's important. And you want to show signs of discussing that your pitch with anyone higher up command, anyone that can really make that decision. Because if they're not the decision maker, we're wasting our time. So I want you to put these four steps together for you. And then I want you to really look at it. So let me give you an example. So the prospect will say, listen, Susie, I'm really nervous about making the investment, right? So then I want to employ my listening and say, I totally understand where you're coming from. I felt that same way. And what I found is when I risk, that there's reward. So may I make some recommendations? So based on your budget, based on where you're at, here's my recommendations. Right, I recommend our global leadership program. It's a year-long program to help you get the results you deserve when you do the work. Right, a lot of people think it's sprinkle fairy dust. And we know, as coaches, as business owner, it's never sprinkle fairy dust. So I want you to be clear. I don't want you to overpromise. I want you to really look at, how do I serve the market the way the market needs to be served? How do I serve the client the way the client needs to be served? And if you aren't the answer, be okay to let that go to someone else. Be okay, maybe another business. I promise you they'll come back later. This simple tool will allow you to handle objections, allow you to be clear, allow you to follow a system so you don't get hooked up. Listen, I'm your sister in the journey. You're in business for yourself, not by yourself. I'm Susie Carder. I'm your profit coach. I can't wait to see how you handle those objections.